Senor. Senorita.
How are you? Good.
Who's that?
It's Nick Kessler. It's a crazy guy. Saved up all his money to go to Mexico. Wanted to see the ruins, you know, get into the primitive thing. So he quit his job and everything, and he took off for Mexico City on Monday. Two beers, Rafe?
Because it's Wednesday, they're gonna be here tomorrow talking about their trousers. It's a big, big day here in Flushing. Let's give them a big round of applause. I know I can't hear you, but I know I can pick up what you're saying, baby. The scene is here in Flushing. The whole world's eyes are on Flushing.
This is Lefty Schwartz. He's been sentenced to death in the electric chair. While in prison, Lefty has learned to make better use of his time. He's studying the law to better himself and hopefully get himself out of this godforsaken, inhuman, man-made hell of concrete and steel.
This gentleman can supply it for me.
Well, I could supply it, but the guy you gotta watch out for is Spaz.
Spaz?
He's a sex machine.
Are you kidding me? He couldn't wake me up with a trumpet and a drum.
Well, I went out with him one night, and he got us six nurses by himself. And four of them couldn't report to work the next morning.
It's a tough question, you know, but, you know, somebody's got to draw the line somewhere. You know, I hate to be the one, but, you know, no, they can't do it.
It's the gopher.
Six months.
She didn't even know I was gone, Dan.
What, Grandma? Yeah, he's right here. Second.
Hey, I don't want to talk.
She wants to talk.
I want to talk to her. I don't want to talk. Tell her I'm not here.
He's dead, Grandma.
This is ridiculous. Senator, hang on to that wave for me. Oh, I wrote. I didn't know if you'd come.
Mike, I really appreciate you doing this, but it is just for the money, isn't it? It's not just so you can wear these little outfits.
I'm not even going to answer that. It all sounds to me as one of the great acting challenges an actor could have. You know what my real problem is, though?
Cramps. No, not cramps.
Sandy.
Sandy.
Half of the cabin crew, Mr. Brown, your driver, Rita Shimkus, your stewardess, and myself, Ted Bruegel, your sky host. We hope you have a pleasant journey. If there's anything we can do to make your trip more comfortable, please don't hesitate to ask. We will commence the lunar teeny service as soon as we're underway.
Nervous?
Yes. I don't like this.
You only have 75 more to go. Okay? What's this one?
It's a couple of wavy lines.
Sorry. This isn't your luck.
A large orange juice and coffee. Thank you. Cheeseburger? No, I don't want a cheeseburger. Eggs, couple of eggs. Eggs. A couple of eggs. And over lightly with sausage. Cafe? Cafe?
No, eggs. Cheeseburger.
What happened? What did you tell me everything?
Huh? Yeah. Well, they have to do that to remove the jaw. Ah, consider yourself very, very lucky.
And she's gonna be devoted to me, to my wants and my needs, not like you. Let's face it, you treated me like dirt.
Oh, Lord, another wild and woolly one. Honey, you look frozen. Let me come over here. Let me get you a nice hot cup of coffee. Oh, now, you sit right there. I'll bring it to you. Robert!
Otto's around. Douglas?
Reginald.
Igor.
Hyman.
Schwuck. It's good. Schwuck. I don't know what it is. I heard it on the bus.
David.
Alfred.
Herwer.
Melonhead. Or Lizard.
Huey.
Basil.
Roland.
Names for a boy. Well, my wife's always been partial to Bor-Bor.
But they both do, huh? Huh? What about the animals? Do they like you?
That's it. More. Yeah, come on. You're big. You're big. All right, destroy me. Destroy me now. Yeah. Destroy me. Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Give it. Give it. Yeah.
We need to talk.
I've worked with better, but not many. Thank you.
No, no, no. Oh, you're awfully sweet to do this. Thank you.
I can do it.
Go out the back. You gotta go now. You gotta go quiet, please. You can make it. You gotta go now, though.
Call him a cab, huh? Get the fuck up!
Please.
Please.
Do you like rice-a-roni? How about a nice diet Sprite?
You'll hear it. I swear. They're right down the block.
Hey.
Oh, I like it here.
Phil. You going to the groundhog dinner?
No, I had groundhog for lunch. Wasn't bad. Tastes like chicken. You two run along.
Wow, Larry.
Looking foxy tonight, man. Hey, is your troop gonna be selling cookies again this year?
Oh. That's so funny, Phil.
Well, praise the Lord, brother. Do you reject Satan and all his evils?
Sure.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Can't drive this! But I'm gonna take this opportunity to retire from the game of basketball.
No, come on.
No. No, I'm gonna retire right now, and that's all there is to it. I'm gonna go out on top undefeated and untied. That's the way it's going to be. You go on ahead and celebrate with your teammates.
No, come and help us, man. Celebrate with us.
I'd like to, but I have to ice down my knees right away, okay? Okay, starting. Go.
Hi. Goodbye, man.
Long time.
I'll say. Probably a year for every topping on the table. I heard a horrible rumor. Oh, creepy. I'm sorry. You know, for the first couple years, I felt responsible.
Are you a member of our frequent renters club?
We would like to be.
We have a two-night rental policy. If a tape stays out longer than that, you're not charged the extra $1.50 per night.
Peace.
You wanted to meet actors? They're all here. Every Goomba hitman, Jew lawyer, Irish mug you have ever seen on TV. This is an elephant graveyard of faces you cannot name.
Well, thanks for the stereotyping, Maurice. Glad you don't fit into any pigeonhole yourself.
But all that changed when, according to your testimony, Mr. Lombardo raped you on April 23rd of last year. Is that right?
Yes.
But then in May.
Now she tries to tell the truth, but I just can't believe. Cause there's nothing in this world to stop me worrying about that girl.
Melvin, you don't know what you're talking about. Stinky Magoo was a Republican.
He was red, Tommy.
No, he wasn't.
Yes, he was.
No, he wasn't.
You would know.
He was not a red. Stinky Magoo was a Republican. He was funny.
Well, He was funny. You're right about that.
God rest his soul.
May he make God laugh.
Here, here.
From me, my slow leave, by laborsome petition, and at last, upon his will, I sealed my hard consent. I do beseech you, give him leave to go.
Take thy fair hour, Laertes. Time be thine and thy best grace. Spend it at thy will.
May I have some ice water, please?
You've made a cuckold of me.
I know.
Many times over.
I'm sorry.
And you nearly killed your poor brother.
What's he talking about? Doesn't matter.
Here's in a cage or I'll have to get a restraining order.
Your client has violated rules regarding ex parte propinquity. I'll squeeze in here with you. Let's take the stairs. I get an erection just thinking about elevators.
Bob, you have the coolest job.
Well, sometimes I think I should be hanging out with a better class than animals.
Oh, come on, hey. Have some class, will you? We got mixed company down here.
You know, Dad, genetically speaking, monkeys are...
This. Lip them.
Rip them?
Lip, yes.
You want me to rip your stockings?
Yes, rip my stockings, please.
Rip your stockings?
Yes,
you want
please,
me to rip your stockings?
Please, so, please.
All right, I'm going to rip your stockings.
Yes.
And you tell Mr. Yes. Kazoo, you know, sure. We had a blast.
Oh, no, 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 Miss Harris. Oh, my God. Don't touch me. Mr. Bob Harris.
Aren't you Bill Murray, man? That's Bill Murray?
Yeah, I'm Bill Murray, but let's keep that just between us, all right?
Yo,
just between us. And you guys are related.
Yeah, cousins, we family, man.
The first thing that goes through a captain's head when he hears there's low morale going around is...
What'd I do? Is it all my fault? Well, he's probably right. Most of us have been together a long time. There are others that were here before that.
Do you all not like me anymore? I mean...
What's your line?
I'm a comedian. I'm a stand-up comedian who prefers to remain seated.
That's it? That's your line?
Yeah. Some jokes for your MC.
He writes his own jokes.
They're lousy.
So are yours.
Touché.
Did I see you at the airport last night?
I don't know. Did you?
Yeah. You on a road trip?
Yeah, something like that.
Me a what?
Of stealing food from the people of Ember.
I love my city and everyone in it. And I would never think to do such a thing.
Hi.
Hi.
Agent 13, you are in a tree.
Yeah, communications got knocked out, so they put me in a tree. Old school stuff.
Well, I'm glad to see you're okay.
Yeah.
Well, I have to get going. Would you raise up the walkway, please?
You don't have to get going. You don't have to get going.
Yeah, I've got a meeting, so...
How you been?
Oh, God, I'm on fire! Ouch! You're not a zombie. You're talking. You're okay. The hell I am!
I'm sorry. I didn't know that it was you.
Are you... What's with the get-up? Oh, I do it to blend in. You know, zombies don't mess with other zombies. Buddy of mine, makeup guy.
The event of the year.
And I missed it.
you read the paper today? People are dying in bunches everywhere but here. What are the odds of a funeral home going broke? You have a business that everybody on Earth needs.
These Spanish. Jesus Christ, Addington! Soundproof door.
God, you should be. Listen to me. I swear to God, if I would have known that that was your wife, I never would have touched her.
I don't have a wife, Mr. Poole. I'm a widower. Yeah. Very sudden.
They got away. We have to scramble the chopper.
God, it doesn't fit. It's not fit. The bullets are too small.
Maybe the guns are too big.
Sorry I didn't sit by and let them eat you for breakfast.
Who are you?
I'm with Counter SSVP. You two were about to be terminated.
The only quiet place left to work was outside.
What are those for?
He has a headache.
You do?
It's his sinuses again. Happens this time every year.
I know that. You didn't say anything about having a headache.
Well, he's not going to trouble you with everything, Missy. You have enough on your plate.
What does that mean?
It means, Missy, that you take very good care of me.
Camp Ivanhoe, that's all the way across the other side of the island. You really think a 12-year-old boy could row this far in a miniature canoe?
Most likely not.
It is possible, Counselor.
I disagree, Counselor. It would take him 3 days at least.
I don't think so.
Well, I'm not going to argue about it.
Be that as it may, will you let me know if you've seen anything unusual?
No.
It was a gift.
And the Renoir, too?
Nice cappuccino machine. Who's the astronaut?
Oh, that's my roommate.
Roommate? You got a new roommate?
Well, I mean, I had to get somebody to pay your half of the rent while you were in the hospital. How's it going, Ice Pick?
Best day ever. Greatest day of my life, really.
Pick cooks up a rock candy that'll make you...
He'll pay $100.
$100? I pay more than that for one prescription.
He said... This is for epilepsy, for prostate flaring, and to soften the sheeting.
That should have some value.
For who? You?
Yeah.
He said 100, Vin. You take it or leave this. You can't
explain everything. Your train departs in 4.5 minutes. Here's your tickets.
Oh, third class.
It was overbooked, but the conductor used to be a sommelier at the old Versailles. He pulls some strings. You'll need these for the dining car. One last thing.
Private?
Yeah.
Oh, sure, sure.
You're kind of nervous. Probably your first hostage rescue. Huh?
Yes, sir.
There. No, I can get that one. Thank you.
All right.
It's frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
It doesn't show signs of stopping in a bar.
Of the paranormal. Dr. Heiss, you're a highly regarded scientific authority. Your credentials are impeccable.
Thank you, Pat.
If you see something of true scientific interest in this video, that goes a long way to legitimize these Ghostbusters and everything they stand for.
A game changer, yes.
So tell me, Dr. Heiss, is this for real?
Hell no. Come on.
You know, how about if I did it with you?
Okay, come on.
That was close.
Come on. We'll do a selfie together.
Great.
Some minor league ball, didn't you?
Well, a little class A. It was a long time ago. Mindy, just remember to kill the head.
Okay. Kill the head, okay.
Ronnie, take this thing out of here.
You got it, Chief.
Does my foot smell funny? Because I was wondering...
We're watching Breaking Bad.
What?
It's really good.
It's a great show. Have you seen it?
Yes, I have seen it. It's great. It's not for kids.
What? Was there something bad on?
No.
Yeah.
Hey, look, I can shuffle.
Oh, wow, that's great.
We learned the...
Lines. Three wavy lines.
It's amazing.
You're amazing with your ability to...
I can hear the keys clacking.
Don't rush him.
The question is who gets killed. There's one piece too many, even if we print another double issue, which we can't afford under any circumstances.
A message from the foreman. 1 hour to press.
You're fired.
Really?
Don't cry in my office.
His old man signed a waiver so you can enlist at 17.
Jesus. What the hell was his rush?
His rush was he was doing his patriotic duty.
You make a very good point.
This is bullshit. They should not be showing this on TV. This would not fly back in my day.